If you're visiting with us today, let me remind you, and you'll learn more about this a little bit later, that today's emphasis is on the joyful church. And so everything we sing this morning is going to be on this theme. Stand and join the choir as we sing "This Is the Day." Going to sing it again while you have opportunity to turn around and welcome and greet those around you while they sing. If you're able, remain standing, and we shall continue to sing what is usually a Christmas song, but we can make it a February song. Joyful, joyful, we adore thee. Thank you, and you may be seated. To help us with our joyful sound this morning, our young people are going to share with us several songs at this time on the directorship of Sharon Brann. Sister Brann, are you ready?
Almost.
Sister Brann's ready.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Good job. It was a girls' chorus, wasn't it? All right. Thank you for being here, and thank you for the kids for getting us off to a good start. Let me remind you of, we're glad to have those who are visiting with us, by the way. Let me remind you, Pat, is the meeting Tuesday night?
It is.
Ladies, Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. You see the other opportunities there. Coming up, it's not tomorrow, but a week. We give you advance notice on this. The Young at Heart Luncheon is on the 22nd at noon. And then this is a special invitation to all of the ladies, but especially to the younger ladies, Angie. The new study that will begin in a couple of weeks on the best yes, right? All right, yes, all right, yes, yes, thank you. All right, I'm gonna jump ahead just one, Deb, and then back me up. The Lenten services, the community Lenten services begin this evening. This is throughout the county and beginning tonight at the Warsaw United Methodist Church at 7 o'clock. And you'll notice the preacher for the service tonight is Reverend Claude Tate, who is the new pastor, by the way, at the New Zion Baptist Church in Newland. And now you may back me up to the rejoicing in the Lord always with birthdays on this side. Yes, Ronnie Hall. Yesterday. Any others on this side? Yes, Dickie Brooks. Oh, Connie Brooks has one today. And Miss Lucy? Tabitha is up there and she'll be 16. Any others here? Yes, Betty. You got two? They're about the same age, aren't they? Yeah, they're about the same age. Right, Mark? Yes. You're twins. All right. Any behind me? Any anniversaries anywhere? Tara? As we come to our prayer time, let me bring you up to date with a couple of situations that have come into play since the bulletin was printed. Gordon Given is a patient at the Medical College of Virginia in Richmond. Jane Skates is a patient at Regional Memorial in Hanover, Mechanicsville. And Betty Shropshire was in the hospital, But Becky came home this past week, but we didn't get to include that in the bulletin. Others are listed there. Keep in mind those and their needs as we pray together. Father, we thank you for this day. Cold though it may be, we are thankful for all who made it this way, for the children who have already warmed our hearts through their music, and for all who are here to share in this worship opportunity. We pause to remember those who are sick, in the hospital, whatever their needs and situations may be. We lift them up to you and ask your blessing upon them, your healing hand. Thank you for those who have experienced healing in their hearts and lives and are now at home or in some cases in church. And for this we are grateful. We pray for our country during this difficult time, and especially in regard to the passing of Justice Scalia. And we realize we've lost a great man in that. And we pray for our country in this time as replacements are made. Continue to be with us. Bless those in the military. Spread across the length and breadth of the globe our missionaries who take the gospel in various places, and the needs in our own community, close by and far away. We make our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. We continue to sing joyful songs. He keeps me singing. So stand as we sing, He keeps me singing. Singing as I go, my sin and strife, discord filled my heart with pain. To cross the broken strings, service love records again. Jesus, 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 stay my know. As we share in giving this morning, Mike will lead us in our prayer.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every blessing that you've given us. We thank you for the friends and family that have gathered here today to worship you. We ask a special blessing upon the men and women of our military, and especially their families who endure great hardships while their loved ones are away. As we give you our tithes and offerings, we ask that you bless them in the betterment of your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, and you may be seated. This is an after-the-fact announcement that I had here all along and forgot it a while ago. But I've been told that the Warsaw Baptist Church is having their wild game dinner this coming Saturday from 5 until 7. Proceeds to help with their mission trip to Standing Rock Indian Reservation this summer. The choir wanted to do something really joyful for you. Some of you will remember this. It's an old song. If you want to sing along, I guess you can. If not, it's best that some of you may not do that. But anyway, here it is. I've got the joy, joy, joy deep in my heart. Right, some of you were singing it with the choir. You know it, right? John and Mary and several of you. Let's sing the first verse again, Aunt Tara. The word's not on the screen. If you know it, sing it, Webster. You ought to know it. Very good, very good, very good. Our scripture this morning is taken from the 15th chapter of Gospel of John, which is no secret passage to most all of you here today, perhaps to everyone. I read the first 11 verses. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away, and every branch that bears fruit, he prunes that it may bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, but without me you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done to you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit. So will you be my disciples. As the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I've kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. Verse 11 is our text verse. These things I've spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full. I don't know if you're aware or not, but when the preacher announces a series of sermons, meaning one is linked to the other, then that's sort of like sitting down at a delightful Sunday dinner. And here's what I mean by that. Now, when you sit down at the table, there are all kinds of things on the table, but you look across it and you know that you're not too excited about the artichokes and the turnip greens and the whatever else you want to put in there. But you are really tuned in for the chicken and potatoes and the beans and all of that. But that's not the most important thing, because you see over there on the counter, you see that pie with the meringue on it that's three knuckles deep. And you're not too concerned about the chicken or the potatoes or what of that, because you've got your eye on that pie. That's the way it is when the preacher announces a series of sermons. Now, some of you have been with us every Sunday, and you remember back several weeks ago I announced that I was going to preach five sermons on the 5 points that Eddie Heath pointed out in his message on Faithful Sunday. And I've tried to do that. And we've talked about, to begin with, we've talked about the church that is honoring to God, and the church that is pleasing in his sight is the church where the people love God unconditionally. And then the second sermon had to deal with loving each other and loving those outside the church. And the third Sunday, which I believe was last Sunday, we talked about trust among the members of the church. And today, I want to talk to you about the church that's pleasing and honoring to God is a happy church. You see, this is the one I wanted to talk about from the very beginning, because it's such a delightful topic to begin with. And for me to stand up here and talk to you about being happy, then I believe that's what God wants us to be and pleasing in his sight. So I've given it a topic. And my topic today is drinking from the saucer. Does anyone have any idea what I'm going to talk about? No, you do, John Penny. And, well, Angie Sanders, she don't count because she typed all of this up. And I'm going to talk about the secret to having or being a joyful church. And in order to do that, I need to lay a little bit of background for you. And I want to prove to you this morning from the Word of God that the Bible talks about the things that make up for a joyful church. And I would do so by reminding you, first of all, and this may come as a surprise to you because you've read some of those things in the Bible that are sort of heavy and maybe even difficult to understand. But the Bible is a joyful book. Yes, thank you. Sometimes you have to roll your own in a Baptist church, and so on. The Bible is a joyful book. Let me give proof of this for you. For example, the word salvation is in the Bible is used, one or some form of it, is used 156 times. Now, I didn't read the Bible and pick out every time the word salvation. I just flipped open my concordance and find out how many times the word joyful or salvation is used. The word forgiveness is used 90 times. The word joy, or some form of it, is used 183 times in the Bible. So I can stand here this morning and say to you, church, the Bible has more to say about joy than it does about salvation. It has more to say about joy than it even says about forgiveness. And I'm here to remind you that the Bible is a joyful church. And there are many, many examples of this. For example, Job tells us that there was joy at the time of creation. Ezra tells us that when they built the temple, there was joy on that occasion. Matthew tells us that there was joy on the occasion when Jesus was born. And Luke tells us that when Jesus ascended into heaven, he did so with great joy. The Bible also talks about, and the choir has sung about this, the Bible also talks about the joy in the morning that is awaiting God's children. It talks about the joy that comes from those who draw salvation from the well of salvation. It talks about the rejoice that was accompanied by God's people when they returned to the promised land. It talks about in John, he talks about the promises of God are sometimes filled with great joy. And in addition to all of these, it talks about the fact that the kingdom of God will someday come with great joy. And so I can stand here and say to you this morning that the Bible is indeed a very joyful book. It has so much to say about it. Now, having said that, then let me point out to you the key to having this joy of which the Bible speaks. And the key is to be found in this passage that I read to you from John chapter 15. You're familiar with the passage. It's the wonderful, wonderful passage from the lips of our Lord himself concerning the vine and the branch. You remember Jesus said, "You're the branches, I'm the vine. Unless the branch does what? Abides in the vine, then it can bear no fruit." It's just that simple. In fact, the word he literally uses there, unless the branch is vitally joined to the vine, there will be no fruit from that branch. And so abiding in the vine, the branch abiding in the vine, is the key to that. And he is saying in that passage that the secret to a vital relationship with Jesus is to know him in this way. And when you do this, let me read the verse again. Verse 11, John chapter 15. "These things I've spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full." Now, having said that, I can stand here this morning and say to you that God expects his people to be a joyful people. I can stand up here and look at your faces and say, your face ought to be telling you this, and you ought to be expressing it in your singing, in everything that we do. It ought to be a joyful occasion. The church ought to be a joyful, joyful place. Now, let me illustrate this for you. I got to take a time out here because I haven't had my coffee for the morning yet. And so I need to take a drink before I finish the sermon here. Now, some of you remember this. Some of you are old enough to remember this. I learned this from my grandfather. He would get his coffee in the morning, you know, piping hot off of the stove, poured in the cup. And it would be steaming, right? And in order that he might drink it, you know what they did? Some of you are not as dignified as I thought you were, you know. You'd pour it in the saucer, just like I'm doing. And then how did Grandpa drink his coffee? Now, some people use the word sip.
Slurp.
They slurped it out of the saucer. Right. And that's how they drank it, and that's how they enjoyed it. Now, I share that with you because a man by the name of John Paul Moore wrote a beautiful song, a poem. Reggie, I think it's been set to music. And the name of it is Drinking from the Saucer. I've even given you the words. I've never made a fortune and I'll never make one now, but it really doesn't matter because I'm happy anyhow. But as I go along my journey, I'm reaping better than I sowed. I'm drinking from the saucer, for my cup has overflowed. I don't have a lot of riches, and sometimes the going's tough. But with kin and friends to love me, I think I'm rich enough. I thank God for the blessings that His mercy has bestowed. I'm drinking from the saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. He gives me strength and courage when the way grows steep and rough. I'll not ask for other blessings, for I'm already blessed enough. May we never be too happy to help bear another's load. Then we'll all be drinking from the saucer when our cups have overflowed. So what is the key to a happy church? Hot coffee? No. It may be you need to drink from the saucer. Now, I know this for a fact. I know this from a fact. Some of you ladies are sitting there and say, oh, that's just a man thing. Women wouldn't dare do anything like that. Well, let me back up my sermon to you this morning by proving to you it's slurping from the saucer is not just a man thing, as it is depicted in this picture I'm about to show you. When Debbie Wiseman gets it up on that screen for me, is well, okay, there. You want that's Sharon Brann in that picture right there. For but there's a great truth in it, my friend, and the truth in it is this, that we can be a happy people. God wants us to be a happy people. And He wants us to be happy when we come to church. Amen. Amen. Stanley, smile. Yeah, that's good. Becca. When we have reason to be happy, because God's forgiveness, God's grace, God's blessing has been upon us, we turn our TVs on and we see tragedy here and there and everywhere, and we realize we have so much to be thankful for and to be thankful about. And that's my sermon to you this morning. We have reason to be drink from the saucer, for our cups have overflowed. Amen. Now, I could have done this myself. I could have. But I decided not to, for various reasons, one of which is because I can't sing. But I asked Reggie and Sharon if they'd help me out in the closing part of this sermon. And Reggie being Reggie, he decided to ask Tyler to help them out. And so I've turned it, I don't know what they're going to do. I've taken the leash off of them. Not time-wise, you know, because... but come on, Reggie, come on, get things going here. Tyler, where are you? They recruited him 10:30 last night. And so, but they're going to do something. It better be joyful, Reggie. You don't know where it's going to be joyful or not. It's going to be joyful. But this is the sermon in song for the Brands and the Mothershead. Wait a minute. You got to get ready, Sharon.
I need my saucer.
Oh, you want your saucer?
That is not her in that picture.
What? No, that's not me in the picture. But
what you want?
But I'm going to say something this morning, and I know I'm going overboard here, but
you
my heart is full, and my cup has overflowed this morning when I see these children up here singing.
Amen.
And I'll take this off now. But I'm just so overwhelmed with their response, and there's room for more. So if there's anybody else that wants to sing with us, we'd love to have
you. We're not having any more children, are we?
No. We'd love to have you.
Want to make sure that we had two grandchildren all weekend, and that's always an experience, but it was good to watch the youngest one, Connor, at 2 years old, stand up here and say the word house every time that before the service started. Some of y'all were in here. Last Saturday, I was in front of a bunch of girls who play softball, age 12 years and under, and I said to them, repeat after me. Y'all repeat after me. Pretend you're a bunch of 12-year-old girls. Every day.
Every day.
In every way.
In every way.
I get a little better.
Do
it again. Every day.
Every day.
In every way.
In every way.
I get a little better.
Get a little better.
Just try to change it a little bit. Every day.
Every day.
In every way.
In every way.
I get more joyful.
I get more joyful.
Shouldn't we be that way? Sharon talks about that, and I don't know what Don wanted. Don actually never called me. He called Sharon and told her last Sunday something. Do something. I don't know what we're doing. That's how it works. That's right. I just, she's my personal agenda secretary. So we're going to sing some songs. We don't know what order we're going to do in them. Tyler and I went over them at 10:30 this morning. And I left the radio station in Tappahannock at about 10 o'clock, 10:03. And so here we are. Y'all, I want y'all, if you know some of these things, sing along with us. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the save of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, all is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. See, that's being joyful. I've got a home in glory land that outshines the sun. I've got a home in glory land that outshines the sun. I've got a home in glory land that shines the sun. Look away beyond the blue. Do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Look away beyond the blue. Grab some wings. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away,
swing low,
sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home, swing low. Coming for to carry me home. Stop right there, down the road just a bit. There's some people that are over 61 too. That's where I am. So I got to take a breath. But as we do, I want everybody kind of sway this way. Sway back this way. Okay, sway this way. Okay, y'all sway pretty good, bunch of white people. But so let's slow this thing down a little bit. You ready? How's it start? I looked over. Well, I looked over Jordan.
What did you see?
And what did I see?
Mm-hmm.
Coming for to carry me home. Well, there's a band of angels. Were you Whoopi Goldberg? Sister Act. Coming after me. Pretty good. Coming for to carry. I love this. Me home. I'm going to do the last part again. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Now, the choir did a great job on Joy, Joy, Joy. Except, as John Penny or somebody over here was trying to help them, and even when the congregation sang, and they just didn't do it, all of it, quite correctly. Because as a word left out, I learned the song right. I learned the song as a little tyke down in the suburbs of Village, Virginia, how to do this song. Now, when I went to the University of Richmond 44 years ago, matter of fact, my laundry bag is down over here in my guitar case, so I bring my stuff in from 1972. But when I went there, I didn't say the word where. I said the word were. I didn't say house. I said house. I didn't say dog. I said dog. And once in a while, I get asked the question, if I slip back into my former University of Richmond days, where are you from, Canada? House. So we're going to sing where. I've got the joy. We can't leave here today not singing where. So we're going to do it slow, then we're going to teach you something else. You ready? Everybody ready? Okay. Sway, sway. Okay. It's totally impromptu, Donald. It's where it pops in this old head. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. Down in my heart, I've got the joy, 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 joy. It's Elvis. Down in my heart to stay. My leg starts going like this. I pretend I'm Elvis. Anyway, so here's another verse that y'all don't know. I spent Dr. Radcliffe in Burgess. His dad was a dentist, and he was my dentist when I was in Richmond years ago. I spent $1,100 back in the 80s for a bridge over here. It costs a lot more now. So all the teeth in my head are not mine. Now, I have a feeling if a congregation this large, all the teeth in your head are not yours either. But when we sing this, I want you to make sure that they're in tight, okay? Because we don't want something going flying out through the air. Being joyful here. That would not be a joyful experience. You ready? I've got... Not the second verse. Oh, yeah, here we go. It says, I've got the wonderful love of my blessed Redeemer way down in the depths of my heart. We'll do it slow, and we'll speed up. That music right down there does not have this verse on that. Anybody ever heard this verse? Ready? I've got the wonderful love of my blessed Redeemer way down in the depths of my heart. Down in the depths of my heart. Down the depths of my heart. I've got the wonderful love of my blessed Redeemer way down in the depths of my heart. Down the depths of my heart to stay. Everybody put your fingers right there and push up. You look a lot better smiling. There you go. Let's do it faster. I've got the wonderful love of my blessed Redeemer way down the depths of my heart. Down the depths of my heart. Down the depths of my heart. I've got the wonderful love of my blessed Redeemer way down the depths of my heart. Down the depths of my heart to stay. Everybody go. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have a love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have a love of Jesus in my heart. One last song. I was standing by my window,
on one cold and cloudy day.
No, it's singing.
And I saw that hearse come rolling, come to take my loved one away. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in
want to see
the sky.
All right. Thank you, Reggie. Thank you, Sharon. Did you enjoy that?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. We're going to sing again. You know, God speaks to us and ministers to us in different ways. I hope you'll remember the simple story about drinking from the saucer. I shouldn't ask this. How many of you actually, ladies, you can go ahead. How many of you have really done that? And great day. All right. You have to share. Right. All right. Some of the rest of you have probably. But anyway, okay. Let's sing. We're going to sing again. Our closing hymn, that through all of this, God would do what? Speak to our hearts and glorify his name. Let's stand as our closing commitment hymn, really, as we sing it together, please. Thank you for being here this morning. Our visitors, thank you for being here. Remember, please, the opportunity this evening at 7 o'clock at Warsaw United Methodist Church. And I believe Tara, I'm going to ask them to join me in the closing prayer. This is it. Come on and lead it, Reggie. There it is up there. You know it. You don't need the words, no how. Come on, Sharon. Come on. Don't y'all argue about it. Come, somebody come up here. All right, go ahead, Tara. I'm going to lead it while they fuss. Thank you. You are dismissed.